Could I have everybody please stand and help me welcome in the grad class of MCHS of 2021. Lead us in.
Quite good. And if you haven't tried it, you should definitely try it sometime.
but I'm assuming you've all tried it numerous times. So, I've got a little TikTok video that's kind of going to introduce how I'm getting through this. We're kind of the same stuff. But make sure you watch my mouth as I mouth the words up there, because I think I nailed it. If you could show that video, please.
Gonna know. Nobody's gonna know.
They're gonna know.
How would they know?
Okay, so I know that's not perfect. It could go viral. I know as soon as you get out of here, you'll be putting all those phones to good use there, and I think I nailed it. Miss Corby, she nailed her part. I didn't do so well. So now, what do we have in common? You've completed 12 years of school. I've completed a 12-year run as assistant principal at this amazing school. You're moving on to the next phase of your life and moving on to many new challenges, as am I. I'm heading south down the highway, and you're heading down many highways. Make wise choices on those highways. You are leaders, decision makers, and the future. I'll be doing the same thing, but in a way different role. I think you get the point. We are more alike than you think. I have one more TikTok video that I'd like to share with you. If you could play that, please.
Gonna know.
Not that one. Perseverance in helping the grade 12 class reach this important goal in their lives. Father, please bless and nurture this fine group of young adults as they make their deeper mark in the world. And Father, we know that you'll always have their back. Amen. If I can now call up Maria Shaboka, as she will have a song that she will be singing for you. Maria? our celebrations and things. We're going to miss that. But she does have a little sister, so looking forward to that too. At this time, could Father Trini please join me on stage for the liturgical portion of our ceremony?
Please stand. Let us begin our celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. God our Father, we thank you for calling us in Christ to be salt of the earth and light of the world. Grant that this time of prayer and reflection may strengthen our desire to shine brightly in Jesus' name and to use the gifts you have given us to serve others in love. We make these prayers to you through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for the readings. Please stand. We come now to the reading of the Gospel. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth, but if salt has lost its taste, how can its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything, but is thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hidden. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under a bushel basket, but on the lampstand. And it gives light all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. Just a short reflection. I want to start with a story. There was once three friends who were talking with one another. And they have this one question. What would you do if you just have 2 weeks in your life? So the first one said, if I have 2 weeks to live, what would I do is I will go back to the town where I was born and I was raised, and I will try to help the community where, so that I can return all the goodness that I've experienced. And then they said, oh, that's a wonderful idea. How about you? He asked the second person. And then he said, on my part, I will go back to the church where I was baptized, confirmed, received the communion, and was married. And in that way, I could help the church in those little ways that I can. And then he said, oh, that's a wonderful idea also. And then he asked the third one, how about you? What will you do? And then the third person said, I would just simply go back to the house of my mother-in-law. And they were all surprised. How come? I thought that you're not in good terms with your mother-in-law. Why would you go back there? And then the third man said, to make sure that that would be the longest 2 weeks of my life. Today is your last day in the school. And in the gospel that we have just heard, there's that invitation to be the salt of the earth and the light of the world. The knowledge that you have learned from MCSS, from your teachers, from your classmates, those knowledge can help you make the life of your parents, of the community that you belong, much better. And if you try to become good, then you become light and soul to the world. So my congratulations to all of you, to your parents, and to the teacher staff of MCSS. Soar high and bring also Christ wherever you go. Please stand. We come now to the prayers of the faithful. Jesus told us that when we pray in His name, God our Father will respond. The response of petition is, Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, the desire of its youth to see the gospel message take hold in our world might help renew the faith of God's people everywhere, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For young people throughout the world, that their search for knowledge and truth through study, prayer, and work will help bring about the truth and peace of God's kingdom. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For young people who cannot go to school because of poverty or war, for greater opportunities to learn in a safe and secure environment, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. In thanksgiving for the gifts of friendship and community we have found here at Warrenville Community High School, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. In thanksgiving for all we have learned this year that has made us become better people, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all students and staff who will be leaving us at the end of this school year, that they may continue to be the light of Christ for others, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
As we remember the blessings of this school year and look forward to the summer and fall, let us unite our prayers spoken to those in our hearts with the prayer of Jesus using the word He gave us. Together, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Let us pray. God, our Father, we give you thanks for bringing these young people to this special moment in their lives. We ask you to accompany them as they face new adventures and challenges. May the paths they take always lead to you and the eternal joy that is their inheritance through baptism. We make this prayers to you in the name of Jesus your Son. Amen. The Lord be with you. And the mighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Please be seated.
Thank you, Father Trini, and Division Chaplain Doug Kramer. It's also Doug's birthday today, so happy birthday, Doug, for coming and being part of our graduation ceremony. At this time, I'd like to call Mr. Hinks back up to the mic, as he will now give the principal's address. Mr. Hinks?
Okay, let's take care of a couple of things first. On behalf of MCHS, I'd just like to thank everyone involved in making this event happen this year. Father Trini, of course, Chaplain Kramer, students, staff, family, and friends, our grant committee, Infinite Event Services, and I'd like to give the biggest thank you at all to Mrs. Christensen for the work she puts in every year. She's the one that gets us. She's the one that gets us all organized and makes sure grant runs smoothly. Also, over the summer, it'll be good to see her nails grow back, as I'm sure trying to figure this all out would have been nerve-wracking for anyone. So, good to see that back. So, what's everybody think of the gym? Now, I know Mr. Michael doesn't like to dwell on the past, and that's fine, but I'm going to dwell on the past for just a little bit, because it has been a very interesting year. So, it's been a long year of social distancing. Mask wearing, and of course, learning in a very different way. This year also marked many things we were not allowed to do. This year we couldn't go to a festival, we couldn't play volleyball, we couldn't play basketball, we couldn't do cheer, we couldn't celebrate our accomplishments the way we wanted to. Poor Mr. Cortez couldn't even do Urban Ag the way he wanted to this year. We couldn't even go to Chaplain Kramer's house to have our yearly pansy pizza. That said, and although we were limited, we did do a couple of things this year that I wanted to highlight. We were able to feed the hungry. We were also able to let those who were shut in know that we were thinking about them by providing cards and letters to Aspen House. Very nice. Believe it or not, we actually did have a drama production this year. Although it was extremely different this year without a live audience, Mrs. King managed to do auditions and put together a small cast and crew of about 14 students. Students were also able to show their creativity and contribute to this year's Hollywood theme. Check out a couple of these classic films portrayed by some familiar actors you may know. First up, who can forget the classic film starring Brenna and Molly in Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure? Looking really good there. One of the all-time great horror movies that you probably all remember starring Davina and Ashley, The Shining, right? How about this comedy classic starring Jada and Caitlin, Step Brothers? How Mr. Bodner got in there, I don't know, but he looks very awkward in that picture. Check out Jacob, Caleb, Chase, and Ryan, this fan favorite, The Hangover. And that's actually a chip in his tooth there, believe it or not, it is. As we progress around the year, there were times when we had to do online learning. But students were still able to participate in the little challenges that we had. Check out Rachel in her Christmas sweater, right? Very nice. Look at that. She's got stockings hanging from her sleeves. She got the logs rolled up in the fire there. Really cool. Not to be outdone, Brooklyn and Dominique were rocking their reindeer Christmas sweaters, right? Really good. Students and their pets became very popular while learning at home. This is a good one of Jada and Coco, Right? Very nice. We also learn that in their spare time at home, that students will play games like Jenga. And even sometimes when we have to self-isolate because we are a close contact, students still found a way to participate. Look at what Skylar did for Halloween from home. What a great transformation that is. Speaking of transformation, take a look at Connor. Right, looking sharp there, Connor. Now take a look at him from a few years ago. Bah humbug indeed. Very nice. This class has been a lot of fun to have at MCHS these last few years, but last week they went above and beyond to have some fun. Last week they decided they would do a few pranks at the school. When I showed up in the morning, this is the first thing I saw. They had completely blocked off staff parking. They had parked like this, but I gotta say, I was very grateful because they saved one parking stall for me, so thank you. I appreciate that. And it was a rainy day, so staff were like, oh no. After getting into my vehicle and walking up to the school, the fun didn't stop. As I was approaching the school, I saw this. Thank you for the offers of $2, $200, and $500, but I just couldn't go for that. Sorry about that. As I made my way into the office, they had another surprise for me. I was told it would either be balloons or live chickens in my office. Thank you so much for the balloons. If that wasn't enough, as I went outside and saw the students on the balcony, they had done this. They had taken the mice from the computers and from the teachers, so they couldn't do anything. Well played, students. Well played. Then to cap it off, they found their way out into our front display case and decided to give the staff a makeover. Right? I think I look pretty good with pigtails. One of the coolest things that student organized this week was the water fight. You wouldn't think getting almost drowned in ice cold water would be that fun, but the smiles on people's faces were just amazing to see. So as hard as this year was, we still managed to do a few things, and the students showed a lot of perseverance and a lot of heart for this year during some very trying circumstances. I only have a couple of slides left, but I did want to make sure that we took a couple minutes to honor somebody very special. Before I finish up, first up is Mr. Michael. There he is. You know, Mr. Michael, you don't take very good pictures, by the way. Most pictures that I get of you are all blurry. I'm not sure why that is, right? But Mr. Michael has been a mainstay at MCHS for well over a decade now, and he's embarking on a new venture by taking on the principalship at Satchers. I just wanted to make sure we took the time to thank Mr. Michael for not only his years at MCHS, but also his years at Primo, and for his 26 total years in the Mournville area as an educator. Don't forget, Mr. Michael is also a local product, as he was born and raised out here. Thank you, Mr. Michael, for your continued dedication to the staff, students, and as well as to the community of Mournville. We wish you the best of luck as you take the next step in your journey, and we know you will continue to do great things. Congratulations. I did have a little story here that relates to Mr. Michael a little bit. I remember Austin in grade 9. He was in the old computer lab that's now the admin professional, and he was researching jobs that he was going to do because he said he wanted to make bank. I'm like, okay, that's fine, right? And he's going through everything, police officers, doctors, custodians, he's doing it all, right? And I'm like, that was my first introduction to him. About a year later, he comes up to me in the hallway, me and Mr. Michael are there, Mr. Michael's talking with a student, and he says to me, Mr. Hinks, you and Mr. Michael remind me of Mom and Dad. And I'm like, what? Well, you know, Mom is serious about those things, right? Yeah, sure. And you know, Dad, he's the guy who sort of sits back and takes everything in, right? And you're like Dad, Mr. Hinks. Mr. Michael is Mom, right? But you know not to get Dad angry, right? Very well said. And then a little bit later on, now this is not from Austin, but Mrs. Cormier joined us in the office. And I found out, if I'm Dad, or Mr. Michael's Mom, I guess she's the cool aunt, and she's dope, apparently, whatever that means, right? So I haven't heard dope since the first Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, I think in the 90s. It's a long time ago. I also wanted to show you a picture of my two girls. All right. Okay. Loves of my life. Joys of my life. Okay? But there's a story in here. Number one, probably thinking, how can these be the joys of my life when I'm holding an ice cream that's as big as my head? Right? But there's this thing that. Last weekend, we go to the ice cream shack here in Warrenville, and Rachel is working in there. And I say to her, you know what, give me a scoop of mint chocolate chip and a scoop of Tiger. I know, I'm just still a kid at heart. They were out of bubble gum. I couldn't ask for that. Right? And I said, for your favorite principal. And then she gives me this. So I'm going up to my kids and to my wife. My wife took the picture here. And my wife says to me, well, that student either really likes you or really hates you. And I'm like, well, what do you mean? Well, she gave you that much, probably good thing. However, if you eat that whole thing, you're going to die. I'm not ashamed to say this, but I'm very pleased to say that I ate all of that ice cream and some of my kids. You know something? You have all made amazing strides to be at this point. You've overcome huge obstacles, and for that, we wanted to let you know how proud we are of all of you. Some of those obstacles are more visible than others, but all of you have overcome something to be here today. At this time, however, I want to send out a huge shout out to Denali and the Coughlin family. I just want to simply say how much it warms all of our hearts to have you here today. In closing, I just wanted to share with you how important I think it is to celebrate this day with the people who matter most to you. I know when I was your age, I was thinking a lot about grad on my day, mostly safe grad, gathering with friends, things like that. As I've gotten older, though, and I look back at my grad day, I can't help but think about my parents, my family and friends, and of course the many blessings that God has given me. All of those people who helped support me and get me to where I needed to be. So if I can offer you one piece of advice today, I would hope that just for a minute, that you put aside all the hoopla and tell those people who mean the most in your life, thank you. Thank you for your support, love, and for helping me get here today. Trust me when I say it will be time well spent. Finally, on behalf of everyone at MCHS, we want to say congratulations to all of our grads. Well done. God bless. Go Wolves. And in honor of Mr. Michael, I'm out.
Thank you for Mr. Hinks, and I'm definitely the mother, I guess. Now, the most important part of our day is about to occur. If Mrs. Christensen could please come to the stage with Mr. Hinks, and it's time for presentations of the diplomas. Just to note that Life Touch is here and they'll be taking the photos. We can't have people moving up to take photos, so if you could please remain where you are. I know it's lots of sitting. And then those photos are available for 2 weeks after for no charge. You'll get a code as you leave, but it's only a two-week window to get that photo. So please be mindful of that. I'll turn it over to Mrs. Christensen and Mr. Hinks.
To the stage. We just wanted to say congratulations, graduates. We are so proud of you and we're so thrilled to actually be here today celebrating this. You can imagine what a year it's been. Truly an entire year trying to figure out plans A to Z, I think we pretty much had figured out. And so we're so thrilled to actually be live with you here, half of the class, but still here as a big group gathered today. Ethan Etchemichuk. Ethan plans to return to MCHS and apply to the U of A to get into business. We're still in the draft, but we should tell you as well. We're asking for one clap, so I'll say their name and what they're planning to do next year, and then if you would join us in a round of applause for each graduate. Jared Adams. Jared is going to work through the summer and go to NAEP next year. Continue being creative, pre-native.
Begin his plan to rule the world.
King's University of Edmonton to begin his Bachelor of Science in Chemistry, right after my heart. Austin Heyer. Next year, Austin will attend NAEP for Carpentry. Victoria Hill. Victoria plans to take a year off in order to work and upgrade, then go to university the following year for health science. Paige Howells. Paige plans to take a gap year to work and upgrade. Dominique Jackson. In the fall, Dominique will take the Northwest Admin course in MCHS, then hopefully take a police and investigations course to become a police officer. Landon Johnson. Landon plans to focus on his career of being a heavy-duty mechanic. Ryan Johnson. Ryan will continue working at Dow Chemical, pursuing his journeyman electrician ticket. Adriana Jones. Adriana is going to work and probably focus on looking into a career in trades, but she still isn't sure. Mitchell Kabe. Mitchell plans to continue working in the construction field with RDP Construction. He will begin working on an apprenticeship in construction in the next couple of years. Mitchell is looking forward to becoming more independent, starting with moving out of his parents' place. Jessie Krupa. Jessie will take a year off to work on the farm with her family. She wishes to go back to school eventually, but right now she plans to focus on helping around the farm to expand her knowledge of agriculture and put it to good use later down the road. Brooklyn Landry. Brooklyn plans to upgrade classes and work next year. Bryden Large. Next year, Bryden plans to work and travel. Anna Lesberg. In the fall, Anna plans to upgrade and see where life takes her. Maya Matsuba. Maya plans to retake a couple of classes while working, then go to university to get her Bachelor of Education the following year. Tamiko Matsuba. Tamika is going to upgrade a couple of classes and the following year get into university for her Bachelor of Education. Joshua Menier. Joshua is going to move to the mountains till he runs out of money. Talia Miranda. Talia is taking a year off to work and then go to university for social work. Caitlin Mojali. Caitlin will take a year off to work and pursue post-secondary schooling at NAEP. Abby Moore. Abby is attending NAEP to pursue personal fitness training. She would also like to pursue a Bachelor of Education with a Phys Ed major. Abby will be working at Orange Theory Fitness as well. Rachel Morrissey. Rachel is going to attend NAEP in the fall for her Bachelor of Business, and she'll be working with Vector Marketing while taking her classes. Sierra Palma. In the fall, Sierra is going to attend the Northwest Admin course at MCHS. Weston Parkinson. Weston plans to join the military and serve his country. Jada Rio. Jada will move away in July to take some time to live a little and make big bucks. She'd like to give a shout out to everyone who put up with her BS throughout the years. Art School to work toward a degree in character design and illustration. Lilia Richardson. Lilia is going to take a Bachelor of Science in Nursing at the University of Alberta in the fall. Gavin Rodas. Gavin plans to get into NATE and enroll in Automotive Technician and work towards becoming a mechanic. Ethan Scalabero, a.k.a. Scully. This summer, Scully is going to BC to become a Master Blaster. Brianna Scousville. In the fall, Brianna is going to attend Grand McEwen University for her Bachelor of Science in Biological Sciences. Sophia Soria. Sophia is going to come back to MCHS to fit in classes she could not fit into her schedule and pursue her art business in her free time. She is hoping to get into sciences for post-secondary next year. Brenna Stewart. Brenna is going to go to the U of A for a Bachelor of Science degree. Kirsten Tolsma. Next year, Kirsten plans to work. Jade Van Lesberg. Jade is taking a year off to complete the Norquest Admin course at MCHS before going into education the following year. Kendall Weiss. Kendall plans to take a year off to work and then go into interior design. Jacob Wichard. Jacob is attending NATE to take power engineering in the fall. Once again, congratulations to our graduates.
Concludes pretty much everything. I do have some thank yous to say. We'd like to thank all the staff. There's been a ton of work put into this to make this day a reality in these difficult times. And it's a huge, huge undertaking. And so thank you for making this, I know, will be our most memorable grad of our lives. So 2021, you grads, you're in. We will never forget this. At this time, I'd like to ask all the grads to please stand. Families, if you could remain seated for now, we are going to have to have you exit via me telling who to go when. But grads, if you could stand up. Actually, parents, please stand too, because we're going to say a real goodbye to these guys as they make their way. And I don't know about you, but Brett Kissel nailed that. Right? So it's your time to have some fun. Right? So at this time, I would like to have the honor to say to the grad class of 2021, we'd like you to make your STEAM exit. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Let me exit in from this side first.